Hear ye, hear ye. What's the soup, lord, ladies, and squires? Welcome back to this here channel. Today we're diving into the wild, wild world of professional medieval knight fighting. Yeah, you heard me right.
Professional medieval knight fighting.
With armor and swords and maces and warhammers and, dare I say, maidens? While partaking in my endless doom scrolling the other day, I stumbled upon these athletes that I didn't know existed, much less had professional leagues, rules, and dedicated fans. I mean, I definitely knew about medieval times and Renaissance fairs. You know, medieval times, the family diner theater restaurant featuring staged medieval style games, sword fighting and jousting, the perfect place where your stepdad Carl could take you to get hammered on pitchers of beer but still be an excuse to take you with him so your mom wouldn't get mad at him.
You know the place?
Or Renaissance fairs, the largest outdoor gatherings with crowds of deodorant hating protesters.
Can you say P.U.?
Stinky. No, I'm kidding. They're both actually pretty fun. I've been to both medieval times and Renaissance fairs and they've both been a blast, honestly. Funny side story, when I was in the 8th grade, my school took us all on a trip to Washington to learn about the US government, but during that trip, they also took us to medieval times. And I got in a lot of trouble because I got way too into the festivities and definitely didn't let my best color shine through. But anyway, what I'm talking about today is completely different. What I'm talking about today is a professional sport with professional athletes, rules, leagues, and serious injuries. So far in my research, I've come up on two leagues. One's called M1 Medieval.
M1 Global presents.
Which seems to be just very tied to like UFC style MMA fighting, where the ring is like a modern octagon and there's professional lighting and everyone in the crowd is just dressed normal and there's like a ref who's dressed like a ref. And it's basically one versus one fighting where everything just seems like two guys are gonna come out and just fight normally, like they would in any UFC fight. But all of a sudden it's two dudes in complete medieval armor who just beat the shit out of each other. I'm serious, guys. This is some of the most barbaric fighting I've ever seen. And it's also super hilarious because it seems like it's almost a prank. It seems like they kind of just snuck these two fighters in at the end. Everyone from the commentators to the spectators to even the refs seemed like they didn't know that this was gonna happen. It's seriously hilarious to see the facial expressions on the people who are just watching this fight and listening to the commentators just be completely out of their element when trying to figure out how to commentate. Seriously, guys, check this out.
What do you think we're gonna see in this fight?
I have no idea, Jared. This is probably the wildest thing I've ever seen take place at an MMA event.
I mean, they generally don't know what's going on. I mean, the fact that they're trying to decipher what their eyes are looking at just makes it so much better. I feel like we're in on this with the commentators as well. I feel just as confused as they are.
A guy who needs to be in arm as the referee, because if one of those swords comes anywhere near him, he doesn't look very, very well protected.
He might be the bravest man in that ring right now.
I'm sure the announcer's quick enough to get out of there. You see him run away there.
Immediately.
That's so true. Like, what's the ref going to do? How's the ref going to separate this fight? He's prone to catch a hit from a sword, or, I mean, just the armor itself is enough to knock any human out. And then, I don't know if you caught the referee just running away. Gold. Doesn't it seem like these two guys are just getting pranked? I mean, they're just not taking this fight seriously at all. To be fair, I don't know how I'd react to this. If my job was to comment on MMA fighting and all of a sudden I saw these two knights of the realm go at it in the ring. And then there's a way more immersive International Medieval Combat Federation. This seems to be like an organization who take this medieval fighting sport very seriously and honestly make a whole spectacle out of it. It's kind of like a Renaissance fair, but where the people who are reenacting the fights aren't reenacting the fights and are fighting to their death. There's official teams and there's even like a World Cup for this where all these different countries get to participate in this massive tournament. There's a really cool Vice documentary from 7 years ago that goes into one of these World Cups or one of these world tournaments. And guys, I highly recommend you go check this out, because obviously it's very entertaining, but second of all, the fights you get to see are pretty cool. I mean, I'm not someone who enjoys violence, can't really watch boxing or MMA, but this was really fun to watch. It was like watching an episode of Game of Thrones, but I don't know, it just felt more real. Obviously, I mean, it's happening, these are real athletes, but also just seeing all these countries battle it out makes it seem just very sportsmanlike. I don't know, I like it. But yeah, guys, the International Medieval Combat Federation, wow, that's a long thing to say, it's just a lot more interesting. It has a lot more different kinds of fighting. There's a traditional category of one versus one with different types of weapons. There's long sword, sword and shield, and pole arm, which is just these three different kinds of weapons that contestants or warriors use against each other. And then there's melee. This is like the free-for-all of medieval fighting. This is like Super Smash Bros to the max. I mean, guys, if you like Skyrim or if you like any medieval game and you like to watch professional live sports, this could be the ideal balance of perfection for you. Because this is live sports with just the exhilaration of good old medieval destruction. I mean, here it is. There's like 3v3 women's melee or melee. I don't know how to pronounce that. But yeah, then there's the 5v5 men's melee, 10v10 men's melee. That's 10 people against 10 people. And there's a 16v16. Oh, apparently there's also now a 30v30, but on the Vice documentary that I saw, they only did the 16v16. And again, here's some footage of it, and it's barbaric. It's insane. I mean, how crazy is that? That is legitimately just people trying to kill each other. I mean, I wonder how hurt you have to get to just like stop doing this altogether. But I mean, people seem to be very happy and enjoy this, so I kind of want to try it. Am I crazy for wanting to try it? I kind of did some digging and saw some interviews of some of the contestants who go a little bit into how and what brought them into the sport. And it seems like it's just a lot of people who are genuinely very passionate about history. So in my opinion, it almost seems like it's one of the more interesting sports, according to my interests as well. Again, I love everything medieval. I do love history, or just the parts of history that involve this era, just because it seems so romanticized.
Fart in your general direction. Your mother was a hamster and your father smelt of elderberry.
There's just so much passion. It seems like it's such a great tight-knit community. That Vice documentary goes a little bit into the camaraderie of all of this. Check out how many teams there are. Europe basically has a team for each country. And then in the Americas, there's Argentina, Canada, and Mexico. I mean, it's weird because in the Vice documentary, the United States had a team. So I wonder what happened to their team. Then there's China, Japan, and Asia. And then there's New Zealand, Australia. And then there's South Africa, which is pretty cool. I mean, there's like a lot of countries who are participating in this medieval fighting. I don't know. I feel like I definitely have to try it. I feel like in one of my later videos, I'll try to find if there's any clubs in Mexico City and maybe film myself trying to become a medieval warrior. I feel like it'd be a fun activity and maybe a fun video to film. But again, that's maybe down the line. Right now, I feel like not ready for all that intensity. This was a super fun dive for me. It just kind of like fell on my lap, so I didn't really know what my next video was gonna be. This seemed like something fun that I could maybe share with you guys. Yeah, anyway, I hope you learned something from this video, or at least reignited your undwindling love for medieval anything. May that be Game of Thrones, House of the Dragon being around the corner, and by around the corner, I mean a year, because that's how long it's gonna take for the next one to come up. But maybe this will quench that thirst for brutalist, gory violence. Anyway, guys, that's gonna be it for today. I'll catch you next time. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on the notifications if you want to see when my videos come out, and stay tuned for the next one. Until then, peace.